to sign and to send to the various agencies with the addresses and emails provided to approve that. If you haven't sent in a request, at this time I will not require due to the number of media requests. I appreciate everyone's cooperation and patience. Again, you're here only to video or to photograph the defendant. No one else. No one else in the courtroom is to be photographed or videoed. And I want to make that clear, please. Where's Ms. Case?
She's talking to her client.
I'm going to ask that we, yesterday, the defendant, number one and number two, Mr. Abston Henderson, stated that his current legal correct true name is Henderson. So if we could change that for the record, based upon his statement as to his current name, his true valid name, to be Cleotha Henderson. Based upon his statement. The court started a little bit later this morning due to a request for in-chambers discussion with the state prosecutor's office and appointed counsel from the Office of the Public Defender. And the appointed counsel, Ms. Jennifer Case. I'll hear from her on her motions here in just a moment concerning representation. And I'll allow Ms. Case to discuss that with Mr. Henderson right now. And I'll certainly hear from the state as well. Are you ready?
Your Honor, I have discussed matters with Mr. Henderson this morning, and he does confirm that he would like to be referred to as Henderson.
Thank you.
Your Honor, I have raised an issue with the court, brought it to your attention this morning, and I've explained to my client that until the issue is resolved, there can't be any hearings held in the case. Mr. Henderson,
all right. Statement to be heard.
We understand that, to Your Honor. We have asked Your Honor, with Ms. Case present, and filed a written motion. Obviously, Mr. Henderson had not been charged with murder at the time of his arraignment yesterday. He now has. We've asked Your Honor to consider that change in circumstance and temporarily show no bond set on Mr. Henderson, acknowledging full well that he has the right to a hearing at a later date. And understand Your Honor's going to resolve the other issue quickly.
Thank you. Anything quick? Anything else?
No.
Right. The motion previously filed by defense counsel concerning extra judicial statements being made regarding the case will be considered. That was filed by current counsel. An issue has been raised by defense counsel concerning representation. In order for me to resolve that issue, I need certain records from various courts and from the state to hear from them with anything they want to file in response, as well as the current counsel, Ms. Case. And I think we're pretty much close to that, but there are several decisions and records that I need to make a decision. So I'm going to order at this time that Mr. Henderson, based upon the new charge, Mr. Henderson, you're now charged with first-degree murder. I did advise you yesterday concerning the other charges, especially aggravated kidnapping, tampering with or fabricating evidence in a criminal case. The bond in that case was set at $500,000. And now in this case, the state has filed and you are charged with first-degree murder. So in light of the change of circumstance with the additional charge in that case, first-degree murder I'm going to order that there be no bond. The $500,000 bond will be revoked pending a hearing for bond. And to have a proper lawyer represent you on that in light of Ms. Case's issues that were raised, which I'll not go into until I can resolve them, hopefully by tomorrow, and see about another lawyer for you if necessary. First, I have to make a ruling on the motion filed by current defense counsel. So the status of the case will be that your cases, Mr. Henderson, are set for tomorrow, which is September the 8th, on the first case, the record 22018222, on the additional charge having been filed in that case of first-degree murder, there will be no bond set pending a hearing for a bond. A hearing on that bond. No bond. In the second case, 22018270, on the charge involving theft, identity theft, and fraudulent use of a credit card, there'll be no bond set in that case. So the defendant held without bond, pending a bond hearing with counsel. I'll try to resolve these issues as quickly as possible. I'll hold them for tomorrow. There are, as I've said, a few documents and court records that I need to review, which counsel are making every effort to get to me as quickly as possible, so I can make a ruling by tomorrow to see whether there needs to be a change of counsel or not. So we'll hold the cases for tomorrow so I can make that review, research, and make a ruling. And we'll take it up in the morning. Tomorrow is September the 8th. And pending my decision, Mr. Henderson seems to be held without bond. Tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. Mr. Van Hulen here.